Hello everyone! Welcome to my class in Fundamentals in Accountancy, Business, and Management. I'm Teacher Jonna of ABM. Now let us continue our discussion of the preparation of the bank reconciliation statement. Okay, we have studied last week that the bank reconciliation statement is a necessity for all entrepreneurs because we need to adjust our book balance and the bank balance so that they would tally. Okay, and now I have given an assignment on the last week's video lesson, and here is the here is the answer. We will prepare the bank reconciliation statement of Justin Trading. Okay, from this problem, you will try to analyze and prepare the bank reconciliation. The bank reconciliation statement of Justin Trading has a balance per bank of 50,346 on March 31, 2019. Because we received a monthly bank reconciliation statement from the bank, and this is where we got this data. We got the 50,346 from the bank statement we received from the bank on March 31, 2019. And on same date, the balance of cash per book is 45,678.30. So you will notice that the balance per bank and the balance per book of the cash do not tally. So these two balances, our objective is these two balances should tally, but we need to prepare the reconciling items, and finally we will be able to get the adjusted book balance, which is equal to your adjusted bank balance. Okay, one of the reconciling items is the deposit in transit. There is a total of deposits in transit on March 31, deposit, but received by the bank on April 1, 2019 in the amount of 22,145. So this is deposit in transit for the bank, a reconciling item of the bank. Then we have outstanding checks issued by the books or by the company, but the payee did not present it to the bank yet. So that means outstanding checks have already been recorded in the books, but not yet in the bank. Okay. Then there was error. Okay. Errors. Justin Trading issued a check number 300 for 1,567, and the bank correctly paid that amount. So there was no problem. But Justin Trading recorded the check as 1,675. So there is an error in the recording of the amount. Okay. Next we have bank memoranda. The debit memo for NSF, including the bank fee of Kalima, 9,989. So what is again an NSF check? A non-sufficient fund check. Kalima issued a check, but that check has no sufficient fund. So that becomes a deduction, a debit memo. Then a debit memo again for printing company checks. As we have said, the charge for the printing of the check is what? For the books. Okay? And that's a reconciling item of the books. This has been reflected in the bank statement, but the book did not know the amount or did not know of this debit memo yet. So the book must adjust the amount by 100 pesos. And however, there is a credit memo. Okay. Okay. When we say debit memo, that is a deduction. Okay. Deduction to the book balance. Okay. And a credit memo is an addition. Okay, addition to your book balance, because the bank was able to collect your notes receivable. in the amount of 18,283.60 plus interest earned of 300 less bank collection fee of 50 pesos. So this means the bank collected your notes receivable. So this amount has already been recorded in the bank, but not yet in the book. Okay, because the company did not know that he was able to collect until you receive this credit memo. Okay, so next is, we will look at the answers. Okay, here are the answers for the bank reconciliation statement of Justin Trading. You'll be able to see the reconciling items of the book and the reconciling items of the bank. Let's start with the book. Again, this is given in the problem. The adjusted unadjusted book balance is 45,678.30. What are the reconciling items of the book? Number one, the debit memo. The no sufficient fund check, that is a deduction to your book balance. Okay? So that's a deduction to your book balance because somebody presented check in the bank, but it has no sufficient fund. Then the printing for the checks. Okay, the printing for the checks is also a deduction to your book balance. And then the credit memo, the collection of 18,283 plus 300 minus 50. So a total of 18,533.80. So the bank was able to collect the notes receivable of the books of the company. So now he has to add it to the book balance. This was already recorded in the bank, but not yet recorded in the book. Okay. So collection of 18,533.80, that is adding already the interest of 300 minus the I think this is the collection charge by the bank. Then there is an error in recording the check. Okay, the book committed a mistake. So instead of 1,607, a check in the amount of 1,567, the payment was 1,676. So you have to add back. Okay, so 108 is an error of the books. So you have to add back 108. So the total adjusted book balance is 64,210. Then for the bank again, we start also with unadjusted bank balance of 50,346. But we need to make the following reconciling items. The deposit in transit. Okay, the bank balance has a deposit in transit of 72,145. So that means this is now the money, the client is giving money. Deposit in transit of 72,145. And the outstanding checks issued by the company but not yet presented to the bank. So 10,214, 5,258, 2,778.4. So it will give us the unadjusted bank balance plus the deposit in transit less this outstanding check. It will give us 54,220.80. So now they are equal to each other. The 54 and the 54 equal, meaning we were able to accomplish the bank reconciliation statement of Justin Trading. Thank you very much and God bless everyone.